What if I would have to go to prison? I wouldn't be able to sit here and talk to you. So for all the men out there that keep spending these $40 after $40 after $40, stop! She the devil! She the devil! $40 ain't enough! You know how many people got $40? $200 ain't enough! You know how many people got $200? A crackhead got $200 on the first of the month. Huh? And I had to notice that. Because there's another thing that had happened. There's another thing that had happened with in my past. I messed around and gave my wife chlamydia when I was 39. Missing $40. That's another lesson that I learned. So another thing I'm gonna ask y'all before I get into the meat of this subject is I need y'all to send an offering. This is the building fund offering. Building fund. We're trying to build up the church, play the music. I need to let's get the choir to give a selection. We're going to play Never Would Have Made It. Because I never would have made it. I never would have made it. I never would have been able to get to where I needed to get to without God. Yes. Oh, God. See, my wife, me and my wife, we've been married for 23 years. And we got 3 kids. You know what I'm saying? And my oldest son, he tried to be in the church. Then he tried to be in the street. Then he want to be in the church. I said, son, you can't straddle the fence. You can't go here and there. You can't go here and fro. You got to pick one side.
Never could have made it.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
I would have lost.
Even
but now
woo!
I see.
Hey!
Are you there for me? I can't
woo!
Say.
Hey!
Never would have made it.
Woo! Even when something
would have made it.
Keep on.
Are you there for me? I can't say.
Never would
have made it.
Keep on.
Woo! I would have lost it all.
Good God Almighty. Woo!
See how you were there for me.
Woo!
I can't say I'm stronger.
I'm wiser.
I'm better. Much better.
Woo!
When I look back,
hot to money,
all you brought me through.
Woo!
I can see that you were the one I held up to.
I love my choir. Cut. Y'all sound just like them, don't they, man?
Cut.
Woo! Ha!
Woo!
I would have lost it all.
Huh?
All right, the deacon just came to me right then. And he told me what the offering was. And I'm going to be honest with y'all, that ain't enough for me to yell. So with an offer like that, I'm going to just have to talk to y'all calmly. Now, if you want me to yell and you want to really get the word of God, I'm going to need y'all to take up. This is what I'm going to need. I'm going to need all the men, all the firm men out here that got a job, all my deacons, I need y'all to put $40. The same $40 you're going to get Kiki. The same $40 you're going to get Shay Shay. I need you to put that in his plate. All the women out there, I want $40 for you too. The same $40 you gonna get Tyrone. The same $40 you gonna get Jerome. The same $40 you gonna get Kevon. I'ma need that. Put it in the damn thing. All the preteens. That's the kids from 12 to 18. I'ma need 10 from y'all. That $10 that you're using to buy that loud. That $10 you putting in the tank. To go see that little boy. That $10 you putting in your tank. To go see that little girl. I need to put it in. Put it in the pot, please. Because it takes finances to build a nation. And I told y'all before, we're trying to put an addition on to this kitchen. And not only did we try to put an addition on to the kitchen, they got a G5 jet. And when I seen it, I said, that's me. I deserve it. And I want y'all to help me get it. G5 jet. It might not take us to heaven, but it'll get us somewhere close by. And God will take us the rest of the way. It don't seat but 12 people. So my top 12 paying members, you in there. You on your way to heaven. You on your way. But you gonna have to what? You're going to have to invest. You're going to have to sow your seeds. And what? Look, you sow your seeds in fertile ground, and it's going to grow. So I'm going to need another offer. We got to take up another one. Choir, finish singing the song. We can take up another offer. Because that ain't enough for me to yell. No. No, sir. Look at me over here sweating like me. Hey! All the single women, I need y'all over here right now. All the single women, I need y'all to come up here and stand up here right now. If you ain't got no man, you single, I need you to stand up here right now. Come up here. Come on. Come on. Yes. 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 I saw a lot of y'all last night on social media. I watch social media. You doggone right. I don't watch it under a perverted mind. I watch it to see how many souls out there need to be saved. I see a lot of booty moving. And I say, Lord, it shouldn't be up there doing it. So I get in their inbox. And I say, hey, young lady, what are you doing with yourself? Do you want to come down to my church? If you don't feel like coming to the church, you could meet me somewhere. I know that it's 2 o'clock in the morning, but God touched me right then. I know I'm mad. My wife know what I be doing. I'm saving souls. I'm saving up. Look, you need to come listen to me. You're listening to that boy out there. Come listen to the pastor. I can be everything. Your daddy, pastor, brother, everything. Uncle, lover, love you. Woo! He bought a shelter with a fair answer, a fair answer, a snap, a hallelujah. Hallelujah. God, hold on. I would have lost my mind. All right, cut it off. Cut the music off. All right, now I'm satisfied with that offer. But before I get it, we got to take up another offer. This offer right here is the Pastor A offer. This is to help the pastor out with all his extra expeditions and all of his extra, what I like to call it, expenses. You got to invest in me. You got to invest in the church. You got to invest in the pastor. If you don't invest in the pastor, listen, this is what I'm telling you. Don't listen. When y'all come up here and y'all giving them offerings and you know daggone well you got a $100 bill. See, this is what a lot of y'all don't know. I know a lot of my congregation got them chime cards. I know a lot of y'all young women out there got them chime cards. So y'all already got y'all stimulus check. And you cheating. You ain't cheating me. You ain't cheating me. You cheating God. I need that 10%. I don't want it in tithes. I want it in that pot. If you got 1,400, and look, especially over there, young lady, you got 4 kids. 14, 14, 28, 28. What's that? 28 plus 28, what's that? Shit, that's 5,600. I need $560 for you, ma'am. And I ain't even counting the stimulus check that you got for yourself. I need, yeah. I'm not, hey, look, listen. This is what I know for real. It's gonna take money in order to build. You hear what I'm saying? See, when I was out there on the streets, and I was out there running all around, and I was caught up in this, and caught up in that, and all this and that, and caught up in the women, and caught up in the drugs, and caught up in the chasing, and all that. See, I ain't had no problem giving a girl $100 here, pay a bill here, do this here, get my homeboy $70 here, bond him out of jail here, buy a pistol here. So now when I think back about the goodness and I think back what God brought me from and I think about where he brought me to now, I come out of my pocket. This is nothing y'all understand. I got to pay them other people, the nigga that gave me the church. And if I keep losing money, he going to kick me out of the church and y'all have a new pastor. We need the money. Yo. And I don't like doing this because I don't want to make it seem like that church is all about money. But listen, man, y'all act like y'all don't got no lights through dominion. They high. Every time, listen, we had church 4 times a doggone week. I normally had, remember we used to have Bible study, praise and worship just on the weekdays. We had to cut it back. That coronavirus done messed everything up. So now the light bill, $700. That's what house is good. Yeah, I pay all the bills. I pay all the bills through God. Through God has strengthened me. So that's what I'm telling y'all, man. You see that new car we just got out there? I had to buy that for my wife because we got into something. And everybody know that when your wife get mad, you got to buy something. You know when she get mad, you gotta buy some. So I messed around. I done did so much stuff. I ran out of stuff to buy. I done bought her a ring. I bought her a tennis bracelet. I bought her a house. So next thing I said, sure, I'm gonna just buy a Benz. And thank God that the IRS hadn't ordered me yet. Thank God that they hadn't ordered me yet. I wouldn't have been able to get that. So I'm telling y'all, if y'all don't tell you, nobody had to file for bankruptcy. We need it. Lord Jesus, and I'm having faith. I'm having all the faith I can. Last night, I sat right there outside the doggone, outside that casino. Because I wanted to get on them doggone fish tables, man. I wanted to get on that doggone fish table. Because something came to me and said, you get on that fish table, you're going to hit. And I drove all the way down. I got up on my bed and I drove there. And I sat there. And I said, should I go in this fish table? Because I know some people in there know me. They're like, that pastor in here gambling. So I said, no, I know that's the devil. So I had to turn around. I said, you know what, God, I'm going to have faith in you. I'm going to have faith in my congregation. So that's why I'm here today. I ain't go to the fish table. Some of y'all see me parked out there. Y'all think I was parked out there to gamble. But it messed around and turned into a mission to save souls. Yeah. Turned into, I got a new member in here today that I met at the fish table. Thank God for her. She came. Thank God for you, Sister Bernice. Thank God for you, Sister Bernice. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And I got one of the best secretaries that you could ever have. And listen, man, I done did a lot of stuff. I done been a lot of places. You know, I...